The tail of the tape between Erislandy Lara and Delvin Rodriguez looks like this. Both men in their 30s. Rodriguez has the height advantage, but look at the reach advantage for Lara, something that we will expand upon as the fight continues. We're set to meet the fighters in the ring. We turn it over to Michael C. Williams.
Ladies and gentlemen, here in Chicago, the time has come for the Premier Boxing Champions main event live on Spike. 12 rounds for the Super Welterweight Championship. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He wears the blue and red. His professional record, 28 victories, 7 defeats, 4 draws, 16 wins by way of knockout. By way of Santiago, Dominican Republic, he fights out of Danbury, Connecticut, the challenger, Delvin Rodriguez. And across the ring, the champion fights out of the blue corner, wearing the camo. He enters tonight with 20 professional victories, 2 defeats, 2 draws, 12 wins, coming by way of knockout. Originally from Guantanamo, Cuba, he fights out of Houston, Texas, the defending super welterweight champion, Erislandy, the American Dream, Lara. And the referee in charge of the action, Celestino Ruiz.
Caballero, te di las instrucciones en el camerino que una pelea limpia y por qué hace tanto tiempo. Gave you guys your instruction, expect a clean fight, protect yourself at all times, touch up, let's go.
It was English for Rodriguez and Spanish translation for Lara, as the title fight will be scheduled for 12 rounds under the unified rules. No standing eight count, no 3 knockdown rule. The referee or the doctor can stop the fight. The fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round. We'll go to the scorecards after 4 if there's an accidental foul. We are set to go. We are taped up. We are laced up. Ladies and gentlemen, buckle up. There's going to be a fight. Rodriguez told us in the fighter meeting he wants to come out and be the aggressor early. He cannot let Lara get into the comfort zone, as he's seen in fights past for the champ.
And where Lara is comfortable is right here in the center of the ring. He can use his footwork, his elusiveness. He's already showing a commitment to that straight left hand.
I like it. I mean, that's where he wants to be. I don't see him doing a lot of movement right now, and that's posed good for him, because I think if he stays close, he can be an exceptional fighter and entertaining at the same time.
Lara, pound for pound, one of the best in the world. A record of 20-2. The 2 losses, 2 controversial decisions, 1 horrible decision, and 1 controversial decision loss to Canelo.
In some people's eyes, this guy's still undefeated.
Yep. In his eyes, he told us, he looks at his career as a pro as undefeated.
That left
hand. He is tagging Rodriguez here in round 1.
Is like a sniper rifle right on target. That's what his coach talked about. This guy is one of the most accurate punchers you will ever see. We're seeing that right now, being efficient. Everything he's throwing is landing.
Man, you're talking about composed, relaxed, and just really knows his way around the ring. His boxing IQ is off the chart.
Halfway through round number 1. Lara already piling up points.
And this is the type of power shots that I knew he had. I mean, this guy don't really have to run, because he has his skill level and talent set is just way above, you know, the guys that I see him fight right now.
And it was that amateur background. Of course, amateur in Cuba, they're the best in the world. Nothing in the sparring, nothing in sparring, nothing in the ring he hasn't seen before.
Rosie Perez, we check in with her every month on PBC on Spike. She always loves watching us. Yay, boxing is on. You betcha. Hashtag Lara Rodriguez. We see you, Rosie. Kid Chocolate with a tweet. Who's watching hashtag PBC on Spike tonight? Hashtag Lara Rodriguez. You folks at home, chime in on social media. We're watching all your tweets. We want to hear from you.
Hear coaches say it all the time. A sound defensive fighter is comfortable everywhere. We're seeing this right now, Antonio. He's not moving, using his legs, but look, slipping punches, hands high, ducking at the right time. He knows when he is and when he is not in danger. He doesn't feel any threat right now from Rodriguez.
And Rodriguez hadn't laid a glove on him yet.
You heard the 10-second thump, and it was a thumping round for Lara in the first. Lara, comfortable, poised, and ready to start round number two.
Look at that, 43% in the first round. That's target practice, champ.
It is.
Five punches, according to CompuBox, landing for the challenger, Rodriguez.
Now, I'm going to go out here on a limb, man, and we may never see this, but this is the type of fighter that's going to take to defeat a guy like Floyd Mayweather. I mean, you got to have the IQ of a genius to compete with a guy that's so slick, fast, and calculated like Floyd Mayweather.
Round two, and you already brought up the big buzzword name there.
I'm just telling you.
Yeah. Boxing. Hey, Lara loves hearing you say that. That's who he wants. He says he's the one guy in the world that could get Floyd. Everybody thinks that these days because they want a slice of a $100 million pie. Well, as these two men battle, we can tell you that they're finally going to battle live and free on Spike. Countdown to Unfinished Business. Kimbo versus Shamrock. It premieres next. Don't go anywhere as soon as the boxing is over right here on Spike. You'll see the preview show inside of one of the most controversial MMA feuds that will finally be decided. Kimbo versus Shamrock. It premieres Wednesday at 11 p.m. on Spike.
Southpaws are tough to deal with offensively. Slick boxers are tough to deal with offensively. Hard counterpunchers are tough to deal with offensively. Lara is showing us all three. Delvin Rodriguez hasn't found a way to get his offense going comfortably at all.
And what makes him such a tough fighter is every time you extend yourself to land a punch, he's in range for the counter. You know, and that's what you call classic boxing.
When we opened up this show, you talked about sometimes his legs take him out of play. He did that a lot against Canelo. He would make Canelo miss, but circle out so far he couldn't return fire. He is planted with his legs. He is looking for the counter shot. Great style tonight against Delvin Rodriguez.
Again, Delvin Rodriguez is not a Canelo now, so you know.
Doesn't have that kind of power. It's going to shake Lara up. Yeah.
Exactly, and that's what you're going to have to do if you're going to unnerve this ice cool guy.
Yep.
You're going to have to hit him with some power shots.
Trip hammer left, keeps coming back.
And man, sharp jab.
Boy, is it.
Not many southpaws have a jab like that. His is light. Winky Wright had a good one.
Right.
You had a good one. It's rare to see a southpaw with that kind of developed jab, and he's right on with it. Which we will see on display in your next fight, champ.
Yeah, I was going to say has.
Has.
When it comes to Tarver. We'll be back. Back live in Chicago. Final instructions here. Ready for round number three. That was Ronnie Shields, the trainer and corner man there for Lara. Ronnie Shields has worked with a who's who of fighters. Mike Tyson, Evander Holyfield, among them. Ronnie Shields told us prior to this fight that his guy Lara is one of the most accurate punchers he has ever seen. The CompuBox numbers agree with that as well. They say that Lara is tied with Floyd Mayweather at 50% power punch accuracy. Obscene.
And he don't waste any shots, man. I mean, he can do 30 rounds like this. He's not burning any energy. You know, he's not panicking. He's smooth as the other side of the pillow.
Watch your feet, guys.
Beautiful right hook over the top. Anytime Delvin Rodriguez comes in. The knock on a lot of the Cuban fighters that make the transition to the pros, they still have that amateur style. Hit and run, get a point, keep it. I like what we're seeing from Lara, where he's sitting down, willing to throw in more of a professional style, trying to hurt his opponent. Great thing to see.
Jimmy, you're absolutely right.
Boy,
look at that speed.
Left and right just gets through, even with Delvin covering up.
But you mentioned it in the opening. I mean, Delvin Rodriguez is trying to box with the most, you know, impressive boxer, one of the most impressive boxers that we have in the game. He need to be making this a fight.
Smarter to swim with the shark than box with Erislandy Lara.
Yes, it is.
You box a brawler, you brawl a boxer. Right now he's boxing a boxer and it's not working out for him.
Man, he got to really use his head movement, weave and bob inside, and then land those body shots when he get close. Now, the knock on Lara is if you're hitting a guy at will, when do you finish him? When you have that fanatic finish, and that's what we have been missing from Lara.
Well, you can't tell anyone watching this fight that there's not a cumulative effect building up right now against Rodriguez. Oh, and the right. That snaps the head back, and he follows it with a left.
That awareness, champ. He reads it, and he's over the top.
Oh, and two more shots straight down center.
And he's not thinking. He's not thinking. He's reacting. And, man, he has some of the reaction. His timing is off the chart.
Yeah, speed beats timing. He has speed and timing.
Yeah.
Watch your feet.
I think if he went to the body a little bit more aggressively, I mean, this fight, it could be closer to being over with.
Now, one thing, he's pot-shotting the head. We're seeing beautiful snapping punches, but he's generally going for the chin. He's not working the body, working the ribs, working the entire body. So, yeah, I think you're right. Get those arms down. Get him thinking about his ribs. Maybe you can take him out.
Lara is not a knockout artist, but he did say in certain interviews leading into this fight that he would like to go for the knockout here to try and set up something with Floyd Mayweather, to try and set up something with a name like Cotto, perhaps. He knows he's got the biggest TV audience watching him that he's ever had in his career, as he has been dominant through three rounds. We start round number four with things going perfectly for the champ. You may have seen the graphic as we were listening into the corner of stats on Lara. 330 recorded amateur bouts. 330.
And I'm going to tell you, it's either 5 or 10 losses. I don't care how many wins you have. It's either 5 or 10 losses.
Right. Of course, born and raised in Cuba, you got to see a little bit of his story as told by himself. Defected from Cuba, actually a failed defection attempt earlier in his life. He went back and defected the second time successfully, where he came, had to walk 30 miles to a speedboat that was stealthily located on a Cuban shore. Got into a speedboat, which if you've ever been on one of those, they don't have spacious cabins, with 35 other people. In the dead of night, sped off to Mexico, thought he was going to die several times, he told us, on that journey. Made it to Mexico, eventually found his way to the United States, and that's why he adopted the nickname the American Dream. This was a man in the camouflage trunks who made $25 a month in Cuba boxing. He made over $1 million for the fight against Canelo Alvarez. That is the American Dream.
Speaking of American dreams, I gotta give a shout out. Dusty Rhodes, rest in peace, passed away.
Yep, this past week.
For many, American dreams, he's one of the best as well.
Many in the sports world paying their respects.
He was a hero in the Orlando area. I remember watching him practically every other week at the Orlando Eddie Graham Sports Stadium. And my great-grandmother, who's resting in heaven right now, used to love her some Dusty Rhodes, baby.
But these guys, working class guys.
Yes.
I mean, that's what we're seeing in Lara. A guy who's living the American dream right now, and man, his skills are on display tonight.
But I think Lara has another gear here. He has to have another gear to step it up to really discourage Rodriguez, because you know what? He's not going to go anywhere if this is all he's going to get. Lara has to step it up and get him out of there. Like the future star he wants to be.
Yeah, through
very
up,
true.
Coming up through four rounds, we have basically thrown every bouquet into the ring that we can, talking about his tremendous skills. He would like to show closing power.
When you want the big fight, every fight's an audition. You have to show that you're going to put butts in seats, that you're going to have a scintillating performance. The greatest of all time, the best, guys like Sugar Ray Robinson could put you away at middleweight. They got ahead, they put you away. Sugar Ray Leonard, same thing. He's got to be in that class. He's got to finish, guys.
He got to finish.
A little bit of a flurry here to end round number four. Well, Chicago, Illinois has seen its fighters and produced several. Take a look at the names here, some of the greats that have plied their trade in the square circle. You can see the Lion wearing the Blackhawks helmet, too. Let's put Bob Probert on the list, maybe. You know, the former
sure.
Red Wing finished his career with the Blackhawks here. He could He could throw the punches when you wanted to. Gloveless punches at that. Stanley Cup Finals and the NBA Finals, both fascinating series with teams trading wins.
One of names on that list, Montel Griffin, a guy you know very well.
Won my first championship against Montel Griffin in Connecticut.
Now, if you're in the corner of Lara in between rounds, are you saying step it up, get this guy there, sit down on some are you changing the winning game, champ?
Most definitely. He's ahead big in this fight. I mean, Delvin Rodriguez don't seem to have the power to truly hurt him. I mean, let's take a risk and let's lay it on the line.
And on cue, he's starting to put punches together.
But I didn't see any body shots.
This crowd wants to react. They want the action right now. You can tell it's almost a metaphor for what Lara wants to produce on a larger scale to get that type of multi-million dollar mega fight.
He's starting to throw a little more into that left hand. He's starting to really lean into it. I think he's thinking what we're thinking.
Well, finally, you can go inside the most controversial MMA feud of the decade. Kimbo versus Shamrock premieres Wednesday at 11 p.m. right here on Spike.
Working the body a little bit different as a southpaw. You can work that straight left right into the liver, right into that right side. We haven't seen him try that yet. Crowd starting to get on him.
You just mentioned that straight left to the body. It worked.
Yeah, and as the crowd boos, I will point out that booing in many European and South American countries is whistling. So you hear some whistles mixed in there as well. I think everybody's saying, let's step this thing up a little bit.
Delvin Rodriguez has been in the ring with some of the best. And Lara, this looks like a sparring session for Lara.
But again, Delvin Rodriguez has said it's his last opportunity. He knows that it's back against the wall. But I don't see a desperate fighter in there.
Well, five rounds now finished. All five clearly to that man. Back live at UIC Pavilion in Chicago, Illinois, Erislandy Lara dominating this super welterweight championship fight. And you can see the damage building up on his opponent, Delvin Rodriguez. Start of round six.
Every combat sport, I don't care what it is, has its basic, its bread and butter. In Muay Thai, it's the leg kick. In wrestling, it's the takedown. In boxing, it's the jab. Delvin Rodriguez has had no answer for the jab of Erislandy Lara that set up the rest of his offense.
I mean, he's just snapped four or five beautiful jabs as you speak, Jimmy. And I mean, I told you, that's the best offense and defense any fighter can have.
CompuBox says that Lara is landing three for every one of Rodriguez.
Ronnie, it's the champ, Antonio Tarver. How you like your fighter so far? What is he doing, and is this what you want him to keep doing? And are you going to push him for this KO tonight?
I'm not going to push him for the KO. I want him. He's going to see the KO. When it's time to get the KO, he'll get it. But you know, look, Lara is a guy, man. He like to set you up. He like to do it in his own way, and I'm not going to change that. You know, he's a very smart, intelligent fighter, and you know he knows what he's doing. And, you know, he's setting him up with the jab. Now he's going more to the body now. But watch the straight left hand. All day, he's going to hit him with the left hand. This guy, he's so accurate with the left hand. And sooner or later, he's going to catch Delvin and he's going to knock him out.
I agree with you 100%, Ronnie. I mean, but everybody's looking for him to have this exceptional performance, to put him in the likes of the Floyd Mayweathers and the Canelo, maybe a rematch. What does he have to do to impress like that tonight, or is that not important?
Well, it's very important, but, you know, but he had to do it in his own way. You know, he's going to knock him out, but, you know, Larry ain't the kind of guy that's just going to run in and try to hit you and knock you out. He's going to set you up. You know, he's come from the Cuban school. They set you up with punches, and then they go for the knockout.
Beautiful.
So you'll see.
Erislandy Lara's head trainer, one of the best in the business, Ronnie Shields. Thanks for the time, Ronnie.
Thank you.
Well, you can tell how cool and composed he is in the corner, because this guy is in complete command, even when the stumble there occurred by Delvin Rodriguez, which was clearly a trip and not a knockdown there. Shields just cool, saying he's going to knock him out. Let's just wait and see when it happens.
Yeah, he truly understands his fighter. He knows the mindset of his fighter. So, you know, they're like they're of one of each other. So, you know, I like what Ronnie is saying. But again, I mean, these people are here to be entertained, and they are being entertained, but they also want that finishing touch.
And there's a shot that drops Rodriguez to the canvas right on cue. 10 seconds left in the round. You cannot be saved by the bell. The count continues. It's at 8. Rodriguez is up.
Now I think we see Lara close the show.
And they'll bring them together, but now the bell will end the round. Rodriguez with a hand slap to acknowledge the great shot by Erislandy Lara, who now is exerting himself and showing he might have that knockout.
And this guy have a style, man, and a gift. It's a gift. I mean, you can teach boxing, but you can't teach what Lara is doing in there. That's God-given talent.
And what I love about it is he's not blazingly fast. He's not super big for this weight class. It isn't his physical gifts. It's that technique and timing.
Well, I think he's fast. Yeah. And even more, he's more quicker than fast.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Demonstrating it right there. Look at Rodriguez as a guy who has demonstrated a chin in past. This is his 40th career fight. He's only been knocked out twice. And a clean sweep on our unofficial scorecard, 6-0, with a 2-point round advantage with the knockdown in the last.
What we might be seeing is the death of a thousand cuts. He's just been hit so many times. Only a couple have been real, you know, power shots, but he just keeps eating punches. You get in those later rounds and the machine starts grinding down. We've seen it a million times.
Now I don't want to keep beating up dead horse with this Mayweather, but this man is the Southpaw Mayweather. I mean, if you look at their styles, how they approach the game, he's the Southpaw Mayweather right now.
I'll give you a choice. You can pair Mayweather with this man right here, Lara, or with the man we saw last month on PBC on Spike, Amir King Khan. Where's the match?
Wow. I mean, that's tough. I like to see Khan and Lara. I mean, that's a good matchup, but I don't know. I think Lara has more control of his skill. He knows what he's doing. You know, he understands what he wants to do, and he knows how to execute it.
61% of power punches landing right now for the champ.
That's equivalent to a shutout.
Yeah, that's Major League Baseball. That's can't miss. A lot of great fighters out there. I mean, you talk about, you know, the comparison to Amir Khan. You talk about the physical gifts, how fast he is, his combinations, stuff like that. We talk about Lara. Like I just said, you don't really talk about the physical gifts he has as much as the technical ability he has. I think that's what sets him apart.
Definitely.
Man, that's beautiful. Hook over the top. That's what stifles Rodriguez's offense. Every time he steps in, it's either a left hand or a right hook over the top.
Even the punches that aren't landing cleanly, just overwhelming Rodriguez, who has to bail out to one side or another to avoid another knockdown.
Talk about being gunshot, man. Every time you release your weapons, this guy comes back and tattoo you. It'll discourage anybody.
A tour of force for Erislandy Lara. The bell starts round number 8. And I haven't seen Lara, I haven't seen him breathe out of his mouth yet either. So the conditioning, along with everything else, clicking tonight.
It seems like your conditioning lasts a lot longer when everything's going your way.
When you haven't tasted any punches and have been delivering the blows, yeah, I feel real good. Our very own Jimmy Smith sitting down with Kimbo Slice and Ken Shamrock, and I hope the National Guard so they don't go after each other. This is before they battle live and free right here on Spike TV. It's Countdown to Unfinished Business, Kimbo versus Shamrock. It premieres next right here on Spike.
There comes a time in a fight like this, if you're Delvin Rodriguez, when you stop being a fighter and you start being a spectator. He's looking at Erislandy Lara, trying to figure him out,
yeah,
but not getting his own offense going. He's just watching him set up punches.
Left hand again.
Like a deer, like a deer stuck in headlights.
Coming from the Rodriguez corner was, you can't stand in front of him, step to the side. To which I'm guessing Delvin responded in his mind, duh.
That's what I'm trying to do.
Yeah.
There are very few cures.
Oh, and the left hand again almost takes down Rodriguez. He was off balance there. I don't know if it was the pure punch that sent him tumbling backwards into the ropes as he stands back now in the middle of the ring. Lara having his way. When does he unload and go for the kill? 10 seconds left in round number 8. And Lara making this look like a sparring session.
You ask if it's the punch or the balance. With a guy like Lara, there's no difference. He punches you when you're off balance. He knows exactly when to hit you.
He has scored a knockdown in round number 6 as we begin round 9, scheduled for 12.
Now, as much as we talk about the knockout, will he finish? The reason we do that is there are two horrible places to be as a fighter. Number one is still having a name at the end of your career and not having the skills to back it up. We've seen that happen. They take beatings because people will still pay to watch them fight. Another one is too dangerous for your own good. A dangerous boxer without earning potential that everybody runs from. Lara doesn't want to become that guy.
Oh, more scoring shots now by Lara, piling up the points. Look, it's to the point for Rodriguez, a knockout or nothing.
Yes. Completely. I don't see a lot of fighters at 154 seeing this fight and going, I want a piece of Erislandy Lara.
You know why? Because he's going to be hard to beat, and also he's going to be hard to look good against.
Yeah.
So he's, you know, double trouble.
The timing on that right hook could not be any better.
And you just don't see southpaws throwing that. You know, I've been in the gym for years. I've seen all the southpaws. You don't see southpaws throwing a counter right-hand hook that accurate. It's amazing.
You taking notes, champ? I know you're a southpaw.
If I throw a right hand, it's just to set up the boom, baby.
Now the pictures tell the story here. The man with the black hair has been having his head snapped back routinely through 9 rounds.
Devin Rodriguez said all the right things in the fighter meeting. And I tell you, it seems as if he had the wrong game plan all along. If this is the fight that he came to the table with tonight, there's no way he could expect to outbox, again, a superior boxer like this with the Cuban pedigree. I mean, just wrong game plan all around.
He told us he was proud, take away the space of Erislandy Lara, but it's been pretty much at this range the entire time, which Erislandy Lara can box this way all day.
And it's old saying that it never looks that easy when you're on the outside looking in. And I think Delvin Rodriguez wasn't prepared for the speed, the accuracy, the timing. He wasn't prepared for Lara.
As we go to round number 10, let's give a little bit of credit, a little bit of love to Delvin Rodriguez. The challenger has taken every shot so far, bent to the canvas one time, but has stood in there. He is the pride of Danbury, Connecticut. Wanted to say hi to everyone back in his hometown. He's from the Dominican originally. This is not a man who will go away lightly. Grew up in the Dominican, extremely poor, had to move up into the mountains. They worked a farm from the time he was a little boy. Couldn't get an education because he had to work for the family there. Moved to Danbury, Connecticut, picked up boxing. His first trainer was Mike Zalar, who's 98 years old, and I'm told is watching on Spike tonight in the nursing home in Danbury, Connecticut. Well, Delvin Rodriguez, your guy, wanted to say hi to you, Mike, tonight.
Yeah, can't question his heart, can't question his desire.
Just, it's a different skill level. Yeah. And, you know, not no knock on Devin, but he's just in there with one of the most superior boxers in the game today. But the knock on Lara is what you see. I think he has another gear. But will he take it to that level?
63% of power.
50% is tremendous.
It's a wipeout, right?
It's a wipeout. 63% of everything he wants to throw with power is landing.
And if you're landing that many power shots, why is this man still around in the 10th?
You don't hit a heavy bag with 63% of your power shots. Like if you push that thing and make it move, you miss more than that.
Unbelievable.
Of Lara's style is he tends to land that big shot and back off. Rather than combo in, he tends to move out after one big shot.
And again, I tell you about his legs. His legs is his best weapon, but at the same time, it's stopping him, I think, from propelling to that level of superstardom because he has everything it takes to be a star, but he just won't put it on the line. And when you have your trainer telling you that, just close, just cool, we got this fight in the bag, I mean, it's kind of hard to get to that next level and turn it up.
You're Delvin talking to him, don't know what he's saying.
Sit still, let me hit you.
Thank you for our translator, Antonio Tarver.
Yeah. Well, Delvin trying to put up some fight here at the end of the round. We'll go to the championship rounds with Lara in command. But at this point, guys, in the fight, it's clearly a knockout or he'll be the loser here tonight. In his career, Delvin Rodriguez, has he shown us anything that we would say, let's see this guy some more? Can he still do that in the last two rounds?
Man, that's a tall order. I mean,
he said, I'm not just suggesting that he should be done or anything. He told us this in his mind was his last chance at a world championship.
At the elite level, yes. If he doesn't show us something dramatic in these last two rounds, yeah. From this is a packed division full of very tough fighters, and it's hard to stay in that elite level.
Yeah, I mean, if you can't win at the game anymore, you're going to have to think about life after boxing.
Quote a great man in a great movie, boxers don't have an old timers league. It's not an easy retirement in this sport.
I mean, I think that's any sport, man. When you're doing something that you love to do, you have the passion for it. As long as you can do it and compete at the elite level, why not?
Yeah, you can be a bad golfer
and you know, won't get your nose broken.
Right.
Boxing's a tough sport once you lose that edge.
Right.
I know you're a great golfer. That's not what I'm saying, champ.
I wish I was, man. I wish I was.
Lara just teeing off. And oh, they won't call that a knockdown. That looked to be a punch at the moment of Rodriguez backing up that sent him tumbling. I don't think that there were feet involved there, but no knockdown as ruled by Celestino Ruiz, our referee.
And you know what you see from Erislandy Lara on that call? Nothing. He goes right back to work like he's clocking in.
Business as usual.
Yeah, no emotion. A lot of fighters start yelling and screaming or get him off the game. He doesn't seem like he even cares.
That's good.
Like he's trying to stick some straight lefts to the body. Something he should have been doing a little bit earlier in this fight. Maybe Devin. Whoa. Devin landed right hand.
I think Rodriguez is starting to slow down. We're starting to see his feet and his legs. They just doesn't have a lot of snap in anything he does. I think we're starting to see fatigue set in, and the punches, they've just accumulated to the point where the gears, I think, are starting to grind down a bit.
I think we'll see Lara really go after this KO in the 12th round if he's still here.
That looked like the first nice shot by Rodriguez in about three or four rounds.
No, the second nice shot in this round. He landed two.
The second one.
Then Lara says, have a little of that. We're going to take another look at the trip as ruled by Celestino Ruiz here to see how much was feet tangled and how much was the punch responsible like that. But we do go now into the 12th and final round. They swipe gloves, and if Lara can stay upright for 3 minutes, he will retain his super welterweight championship. Now, champ, you got everything going right where you want it. Is it just, hey, 3 minutes? Do I want to put on any type of a show here with the last 3 minutes? I don't need to score. It'd be great to get a 12th round knockout, but just don't do anything stupid that could get you caught.
I mean, like I said, I think he should have went for this knockout earlier.
Yeah.
I mean, but it's kind of hard when your trainer telling you just keep doing what you're doing.
Yep.
I mean, of course, he's been in complete control, but like I said, goes back to the numbers. If you lay hands on anybody that many times, that accurately, he's supposed to be knocked out or hurt or something. But great performance by Lara. Great performance.
A tweet from Sergio Mora at the Latin Snake.
And he asked him, how do you say masterpiece in Spanish? He should know that.
Who's he asking? That's what I'm wondering.
Maravillosa. I'm sure my pronunciation was horrible, but I just got word there. That's how you say masterpiece.
He's hit him with that wicked overhand left. He's hit him with it twice. I think that's the shot he wants to get him out of there with if he can land it properly.
Under 1 minute left to go.
Man, another beautiful. That wobbled him. Rodriguez is hurt.
Nope, and Rodriguez says, I still got enough to stay up. You're not going to get me down, Rodriguez says.
Rodriguez is bluffing, man. He's hurt, and Lara should have known that instinctively. He should have put the pressure on right there.
Lara didn't take the bait, if that's what it was. 30 seconds remaining. Rodriguez wants to show a little bit more heart. He'll eat one more left there. And another. Thank you. just dominance by Erislandy, the American Dream, Lara. Almost 2-1 punches thrown. Multiple more punches landed by Lara. The power punches in his favor as well. And we will have the scorecards tabulated. I believe that the cards are in. Let's go back into the ring to Michael C. Williams.
Ladies and gentlemen, having gone the distance, we'll go to your judges' scorecards. All three judges at ringside, Bill Lurch, Steve Weisfeld, and Robert Hoyle, all see the fight exactly the same at 120-107, all for the winner by unanimous decision. And still, super welterweight champion, Erislandy, the American Dream, Lara.
Jimmy Smith in the ring. After the photo op, Jimmy,
I'm here with your winner, Erislandy Lara. Erislandy, a brilliant, dominant performance against a very tough fighter in Delvin Rodriguez. What does this mean moving forward for you, champ?
A todos los que están presentes aquí, gracias por a Delvin, al equipo de Delvin por aceptar la pelea, y a Heyman, que es lo fundamental aquí, y mi manager Luis Cuba Junior. Hicimos un trabajo duro, lo dominé totalmente, no lo pude acabar, pero bueno, hice mi trabajo perfecto. En futuro queremos pelear con los mejores. Queremos Floyd, queremos Cotto, queremos Golovkin, queremos cualquiera, estamos listos.
I understood those names, tell me.
Yeah, he says first off he'd like to thank the whole team, thank Delvin Rodriguez for being a great competitor today, thank you Al Heyman. And he says the future is clear. We want Floyd Mayweather, we want Miguel Cotto, and we want Gennady Golovkin at 160 pounds.
You heard, he threw out the big names. Give it up for him. Erislandy Lara, ladies and gentlemen.